Today I want to share how I make in-the-hoop ornaments like this one with my Janome 500E embroidery machine. I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts. I'm an online educator, and I am the creator and host of The Quilter's Way. It's the only private online membership that helps you improve your free motion quilting skills. Now, before we get to stitching, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. So I've recently been making a lot of in-the-hoop ornaments using my Janome 500E, and today I want to show you some of the tips I found helpful when I was doing this process. Now, the design I'm working on today is a purchase one from Urban Threads, and I'll put a link in the description below to that particular design if you're interested in trying it out for yourself. You're going to need some things, of course, as you always do when you're machine embroidering. You're going to need a glue stick. You're going to need some stabilizer, and I'm using tearaway stabilizer. You're going to need thread, of course, whatever thread you want to use for your particular project. You're going to need two pre-cut fabric pieces in the shape of the ornament you're going to create. Now, in the Urban Threads design, they include a die line piece pattern. I'm not sure exactly what you call it, but it's the die line shape you need to cut out that fabric piece. So you can print that out and you can cut it out from your fabric. If you'd like to know how to make a reusable template to do that, so you can create a whole bunch of these ornaments, check in the description below because I have a video that shows you exactly how to make one of those. You're also going to need some ribbon, because if you want to hang your ornament, you need to have ribbon, of course. And, you know, snips are always helpful. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is you want to hoop up your stabilizer, okay? So I've got mine all ready to go, and it's going to go in the machine. So let me just attach it to my machine. Okay, now the first thing that the machine is going to do, it's going to stitch out a die line. It's going to stitch out the shape of the bell, and it's going to stitch it out on the stabilizer. First time I did this, it seemed really weird to me, but now I understand what it's doing. It's stitching out that die line, and then it's going to ask you, well, not really, but the next step is to put in that pre-cut fabric shape. That's going to be the front of your ornament. So what I like to do is, it's going to stitch out the die line, you're going to put the fabric in, and then it's going to stitch that fabric down, okay? We call it a tack down stitch. So it's going to stitch inside that design, and it's going to tack it down. So I don't like to have to change my thread too many times if I don't have to. I mean, you have to change them quite a few times because you have different colored threads in your design typically. But what I like to do is I like to use the same thread for the die line that's going to tack down, going to stitch down at first, and the tack down stitch, so I don't have to change my thread until at least the third stitching, okay? So let's get this going. I just have to get back to the start. One more. There we go. So here's where it's going to start. So I've got my machine all threaded up. I'm using white thread today. Okay, probably not the best choice, but I am stitching a white fabric, okay? You can see the stitching on the stabilizer. I mean, the stabilizer is white, so is the thread, but you can still see it. So we're going to start this off here. And I don't know about you, but I don't like to have my thread hanging around. I always hang onto my thread. I don't want to get caught inside the machine, maybe. It's just me, but anyway, and then I stitch it off. I stop the machine and snip it off, I should say, and then it's going to continue on. All right, so now it's stitched down my die line. I could move my hoop back to the beginning if I want, but I don't want to do that. So I'm just going to take the hoop out of the machine, okay? We're not taking the stabilizer out or anything like that. We're taking the hoop out of the machine. And you can see that it has stitched that bell outline. Okay, the next step is to get this fabric into that bell outline. And so what I like to do is I like to use glue stick to do that. I know some people will tell you to use a spray, you know, a temporary adhesive spray. I don't like to do that for the mess it makes, and I don't want to breathe those fumes in. So the glue stick works really well. You just need something to temporarily affix this fabric within that die line. All right, so I'm just going to press it down a little bit. Just make sure it sticks in there, okay? And then the next step is to put it back in the machine. And what it will be doing is that tack down stitch I told you about. Again, it's a white thread. That's what I need for this particular project. And then I'll have to start switching up my threads to the different colors. So let me just get this back in the machine here. And yeah, it might be easier to move the hoop over if I want to. But what I'm going to do next is I'm going to start tacking this down. Run that next stitch here. Again, I'm trying to grab my thread here. I'll show you what this tack down stitch looks like. Snip that thread off. All right, I'm just going to pull this out to show you what it looks like. Okay, so now you can see that my fabric is securely fastened down to that stabilizer, and the machine is now ready to go through the rest of the stitches to embroider the front of the design. Now at this stage, it's finished stitching all the details on the front of the ornament, and I need to take it out of the machine, not out of the hoop. I almost said out of the hoop because that's usually what we're so used to doing, right? Take it out of the machine. Do not take it out of the hoop or there's going to be a big problem. What you want to do next is add the backing fabric and the hanging loop. So you're just going to turn your design over and you're going to get your handy glue stick out again. And you're just going to put some glue inside. Now just be careful here. You don't want to break through the stabilizer or anything, right? But you just want to get that glue certainly along the edges is really what we're looking to do here. You can put some in the middle if you want, doesn't hurt, but you want to get along the edges. You want enough on there to keep that fabric down like you did in the first step when you started. All right, so now I'm going to put my backing fabric, which looks the same as the front fabric, right? I'm going to put it down there, but I also need to get my hanging loop put in, right? So I've got my little piece of ribbon here and I'm going to fold it in half, make sure it's not, you know, that's running the right way. It's not caught up funny or anything. And then I'm just going to peel the top back a little bit here and put that in roughly the center of the ornament. Okay. And just give it a little bit of a press there. Now you can see my loop is hanging out there. I'm going to put this back in the machine because the machine is now going to do the finishing stitch to attach that back to the front. I don't want that hanging loop, you know, getting in the way. So I have this tape that I like to use. It's reusable. And I can just put it on the edge. If you don't have this kind of tape, you can certainly use masking tape or painter's tape. Painter's tape is really good, actually. And just put a little bit of it on the hoop and a little bit on the stabilizer. It's going to hold really well. Okay, don't worry that it's hanging out like that. It's not going to get caught in anything. Now you can put it back in the machine. And it's going to be ready to stitch out that final stitch that's going to attach the front to the back. So let's see how that works. We are going to get it to start again. All right, I need to put my pressure foot down, of course, to get it going. And I like to hold my thread usually, just in case. And I like to stop my machine and I will just trim that off just before it gets to the end. I'm going to stop it and I'm going to trim off that thread now, and then I'll let it finish quilting, or stitching, I should say. All right, now it has stitched the front to the back. It's got the hanging ribbon stitched in there. We are now ready to take this out of the machine. And you can see how it looks. Pretty much the same as it did last time, right? But now you've got the backing stitched in and that's holding that hanging loop in as well. Now, before you can take it out of the hoop, you need to take off that tape. Hang on to it because you can reuse it. And then you'll be able to take this out of the hoop and take off your stabilizer and you'll have your ornament all done. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. And for more helpful quilting information, be sure to get on my email list. You can find it on my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.